Formal and informal culture. Examples of some would be business culture, sometimes called organizational or corporate culture, is a composite of common values, attitudes, standards, and policies, performance and actions of the management and employees. It deals with building relations with your clients, customers, and colleagues. There are two fundamentals of business culture, formal business culture and informal business culture. Formal business culture tends to be organized in steep hierarchies that reflect major differences in status and power. Formal business deals with how serious and formal behavior of customers and employers must be. For the owner or employee, formal organization culture is purposely planned. Examples include the corporate hierarchical structure, written company policies, basic operating procedures. Another one could be your military. Informal business culture. Formal business cultures value more egalitarian organizations with smaller differences in status and power, and like formal cultures, formally is all about equality. Hierarchy is absent. Mostly managers discuss decisions with colleagues and take feedback from employers addressing each other. Some examples could be Google, or most of your startups, at least they're portrayed that way. Some very formal cultures would be Australia, Denmark, USA, Canada, Norway, Sweden, New Zealand. Those would be our top informal cultures. Our formal cultures, most of Europe, Asia, Mediterranean region, and the Arab world, along with Latin America, with their strict hierarchies and the societies based with men being at the top. That's not always a formal cultural structure either. That's just an example. Many aspects, Germans can be considered the masters of planning because careful planning one's business and personal life provides a sense of security and control. Business is viewed as being very serious, and Germans do not appreciate humor in business context. German counterparts do not need or expect to be complimented. Germans do not like surprises, especially sudden changes in business transactions. Informal business, a unique team, a plain individual responsibilities, no hierarchy of workplaces, addressing each other in an informal or neutral way. So there's no the boss, it could be comrade, associate, and other ways. Another way for informal and formal cultures could be how you shake a hand, how your eye contact would be, and the way you dress for work. Some people are required to dress very formal. There's no business casual, as you would say. No blue jeans or sneakers. Another businesses with a formal requirement would also give you a uniform. You know, this is less of a white collar, like you're thinking of the trades, you know. The big companies, you're going to have to wear Irving's uniform if you were delivering oil. Or if you were working for Bath, would be informal, because as long as you had the proper OSHA equipment, you could wear pretty much anything you wanted, as long as it met the policy of the company, as not exposing yourself or having rips and tears that could lead to yourself getting hurt. Other examples of formality and informality would be writing in schools or colleges. A peer-reviewed source would be a formal source, whereas Wikipedia, or as we have seen it'd be a big thing in the election is the fake news. So once again, informal behavior. Aspects of culture, whether it's a country or a business, and whether you have an informal attitude in America, it's okay to be late or joking, and to maybe hang out with your friends, whereas in Germany you might not hang with the boss, or maybe Japan, another example, where you're supposed to sacrifice for the company.